Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I did a video on adding a little context to your spark line. And in the video at the beginning, I said I'm going to provide all the steps, all the details of how I built this solution out. And I forgot to show you how to create the report tooltip. And somebody called me out on it, so I decided let's do a video. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, did a video on adding some context to your spark line. You should go check it out if you haven't watched it. And I didn't show you how to create the report tooltip. And somebody posted in the comments, hey, you said you were gonna provide the details, but you didn't. So that's why I'm here doing this video. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you wanna do is add the page and go to the format, expand page information. Let's give it a name. We're gonna call this Sparkline Details. And then you need to make sure you toggle on allow use as a tooltip. Then we're gonna go to our canvas settings because we're gonna do a custom size. Don't choose a tooltip. I chose a custom size because I'm displaying a table and I want the entire table to be in view. So we're gonna make this 320 and we're gonna make this one 500. Perfect. And the last thing I like to do before I design up my report tooltips is put the page view to the actual size. All right. Next, I'm going to add a measure for selected year. So I'm going to make this a card just to do a little test. Turn this category label off, shrink this down a bit. Now let's head back over to the overview page. And now we're going to activate that report tooltip, choose the card where our spark line is, go to format, choose general, expand tooltip, toggle it on, switch type from default to report page, and then select spark line details. Now, if we hover, you'll see, right, that's 2015. Let's switch this to 2016, and then you'll see it changes to 2016. So we know everything's working. Now we need to wire up that table and do the conditional formatting, okay? So let me show you how easy that is. So we're gonna go back over to our report tooltip page. We're gonna grab a table, put it on our design surface, and we're gonna add month because our spark line is showing a trend by month. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab that percent over percent change. We're gonna drop it onto our little canvas here. And then the last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add our conditional formatting. Before we do the conditional formatting, I wrote a measure. And if this DAX looks a little complicated, Alberto did a really good video explaining this, and we'll put a link to the video in the description below. But I use the exact same pattern that Alberto did in that video. And so basically I calculated table, summarizing the percent over percent change by year, month, number, and month. And I include month number because I'm sorting month by month number and I need it. Once I have that table, then I just follow the pattern, grab the minimum from that variable, the table that I created, grab the minimum percent over percent change, then grab the maximum percent over percent change, and then I tuck the current percent over percent change in a variable. And then I just use a switch. I say if the current is equal to the minimum, make it red. That's the hex value for red. And then if the current is equal to the maximum, make it green, and then return the result. Once that's done, all I need to do is make sure my table is selected, click the little caret, choose conditional formatting, font color, change it to field value, go find that field, click okay. And then you're like, nothing happened. Well, let's go back to the overview page and now let's hover over that card. And you'll see March is green, July is red. Let's switch this up, 2017, let's hover. There we go, February and July. Those are the details, those are the steps. What do you guys think? You got any questions, you got any comments? Are you using report tooltips? They're really, really good, especially if you're trying to save, if you're trying to save on performance, because they actually delay the execution of queries instead of using traditional tooltips. All right, you got any questions, you got any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Spark, 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 spark.